Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is decimals part 8, and we're still adding and subtracting decimals containing both positive and negative integers. This is part 2. We do mainly subtraction on this video. All right, let's do this subtraction problem. So we have negative 32.8 minus 2.56. So this is a subtraction problem with and it contains a negative number. So we want to rewrite the subtraction as adding the opposite. So negative 32.8 plus a negative 2.56. I don't know what this little extraneous mark is. There we go. And now we're adding two negative numbers. So when you add two negative numbers, the answer will be negative. And then we need to do the addition of the two absolute values of those numbers. In other words, ignore the negative signs. And to add these, they also happen to be decimals. We've got to line up the decimal points. Lots of different concepts in this problem. So we're going to add here. Remember to put the little extra zero there. And we get 35.36 if I did my arithmetic correct. So the answer would be 35.36, but the negative sign in front of it. All right, let's have you try one. All right, so put the video on pause and try 2.3 minus 6.48. All right, again, we have a number. 2.3 is smaller than 6.48. So we want to rewrite this as adding the opposite. 2.3 plus negative 6.48. This is a little bit different than the previous problem because I'm adding a positive and a negative number. So I see, well, do I have more positives or negative? And the negatives went out here. So the answer is going to be negative. And when you're adding with different signs, you take their difference. So you take the difference of 6.48 and 2.3. Difference means just subtract. So we're going to put the extra zero here and go ahead and subtract. You get 4.18. So I hope you also got negative 4.18. All right, here's another subtraction problem. 32.6 minus negative 2.9. So when you have subtracting a negative, makes more sense to first write that as adding the opposite, which becomes 32.6 plus a positive 2.9. Hey, this is pretty cool. Now we're just adding two positive numbers. So when we add two positive numbers with decimals, you simply line up the decimal points and add. So that is going to give you 35.5. Right, here's another subtraction problem for you to try. Put the video on pause and try that. Okay, again, we've got subtracting a negative number, so we want to rewrite that as adding the opposite. So this becomes negative 32.6 plus 12.42. All right, now what do I have going on here? I'm adding a negative and a positive this time, so I see which is the answer going to be positive or negative? There's more negatives, so the answer is going to be negative. So I'm adding different signs, so this time I take their difference. So the bigger number, absolute value, is 32.6. I'm going to subtract 12.42. Remember to put the zero here, very, very important. That's one of the most common mistakes people make. They don't put that zero there. So we've got, let's see, 8, 1, 0, 2. So my answer we knew was going to be negative, so it's negative 20 and 18 hundredths, or negative 20.18. Right, here's another one for you to try. Put the video on pause and try this on your own first. Again, we've got subtracting a negative, so this becomes negative 11.61 plus 23.894. All right, now I'm adding a negative and a positive, so which one outweighs the other? Do I have more negatives or positives? have more positives. So my answer is going to be positive. Okay, so I'm not going to write anything down here, but if you want, you can put a plus sign. I guess I did write something down. So we go over to the side. If you're adding numbers with different signs, you need to take their difference. So we have 23.894, that's the big number minus the small number. Putting that extra zero. Subtract, and our answer was positive, so I don't need to write that positive sign. It's just 12.284. Okay, here's a problem with three numbers in it, and we have a couple subtractions. So the first thing we want to do is rewrite the subtractions as adding the opposite. Go ahead and try this whole problem on your own first, see how you do. Okay, the first number we just still have, negative 56.1, but we're going to add a negative 17.3, and this becomes minus a negative, ends up just being a plus, a positive 1.8. So next step. Well, we have two negative numbers and one positive number. So I like to add the two negative numbers first. And if you go to left to right, you're also going to be adding those two negative numbers first. So when you add two negatives, you know there's going to be a negative, and we're going to be adding that 1.8 to whatever we get here. So we need to go over on the right and add. These are like signs, so you just add the 56.1 and the 17.3. So that gives you 73.4. So I added the first two numbers here. Now I am adding a negative to a positive number. So now, is my final answer going to be negative or positive? Well, I've got more negatives because negative 73 is bigger than positive 1. So the answer is going to be negative. And now, since I'm adding unlike signs, different signs, I'm going to take their difference. So I'm going to go over here on the side. And actually, I already have the 73.1, so I could go ahead at this point and just take what I have there and subtract that 1.8. And so let's see, that gives me 6, 1, and 7. So if I didn't make any arithmetic mistakes, it looks like my answer is negative 71. 0.6. All right, here's another one to try. 10 minus 13 and 56 hundredths. Again, with subtraction, we want to rewrite that as 10 plus a negative 13.56. And now we're adding a positive and a negative, and we have more positives or negatives. We've only got more negatives. So then we take their difference because they're different signs. 13.56 minus 10, and we get negative 3.56. So hopefully you're getting the hang of this. But why not try another one? Okay, we've got negative 36.81 plus 14.2 minus 16.7. So the first thing you probably want to do is change this subtraction to adding the opposite. I'm going to do this all in one step here. I'm going to write this as plus and negative. All right, so now I notice I've got these two negative numbers that need to be added together, and that will give me a negative number, right? So I'm going to go over on the side here and add the 36.81 to the 16.7. That gives me negative 53.51, but I have to still add in the 14.2. So now I've got a negative plus a positive number, so which outweighs, well, negatives? God, it seems like almost every problem the answer is negative. That was not intentional. And since I'm going to do 53.51 minus 14.2, I could just go ahead and put that right over here, the minus 14.2. So let's see, I've got 39.31. So I hope you're doing all of these with me and that you're getting the right answer as well. All So that's basically it. Now we've done a lot of addition and subtraction with positive and negative decimals. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.